Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos. In this lesson, we are going to solve this problem. So this is the sample problem 2.5. So it says that calculate the magnitude of the moment about the base point O of the 600 Newton force in 5 different ways. So this is the 600 Newton force, and we need to find the moment of this force using these 5 methods, right? So we will discuss these methods one by one. So the first method is that we find the moment of the force directly, and then we use this equation. So the first method is that use this equation. So then what we will do, we will find the perpendicular distance of this force from the point of rotation. So we need to find the moment about this point O, right? So then this force is applying this torque, right? So clockwise torque. So we need to find this D, right? So this is the first method. If we are able to find this perpendicular distance, so then what we will do, we will multiply the distance by F force. So then we will get the moment about O. So now if I see, so then this D is consist of these two lengths. Let's suppose this is one length. Let's suppose this is X length. And this is another length, this is Y. So D is equal to X plus Y, right? This angle is given, this angle is 40, and this length is 4 meter. So if let's suppose if I consider this OAB triangle, this point is B. So if I consider triangle OAB, so then X is equal to 4 cos of 40 degrees, right? So in this OAB triangle, this X is the base and 4 meter is the hypotenuse. So X is 4 cos of 40, right? And now in here, if I draw another parallel line to this Y length, so then we have this triangle, right? And in the problem, it is given that this force is making 40 degree with the horizontal, right? So if this line is parallel with this force, so then if this is 40, so then this angle is also 40, right? So this means that Y length is equal to, if this is the hypotenuse, right? So then this is the base and this is the perpendicular, if this is 40. So then this means that this will be 2 sine of 40 degree, right? So then what will be D? So D, the perpendicular distance of the force from the point of rotation, from the axis of rotation is D, which is X plus Y. So it is 4 cos of 40 degree plus 2 sine of 40 degrees, right? So then D equals to 4.35 meters. So this is the perpendicular distance of this force, 600 Newton. So then we can find moment about O. So then moment about O, let me write it here. So moment about O will be equal to F. So F is how much? F is 4.35 meters into 600, right? So then this equals to 2610 Newton meter. And if we use right hand rule, so the direction is towards the page or the screen, right? So this is the direction. The direction of the moment is towards the screen. So we can write it here as clockwise, and this is the direction, right? So this is the value of moment using the first method. The second method, so now we will use the Verignon's theorem. So Verignon's theorem said that the moment of a force is equal to the summation of moment of its components, right? So this means that the summation of the moment of F1 about O plus the moment of F2 about O will be equal to the total moment of the 600 Newton force. So this means that if we resolve this 600 Newton force into its components, and then we find the movements of individual components, and then we take the sum of those components, so that will be equal to the total moment of that force, right? So this is Verignon's theorem. So now if this is 40, this angle is given, this is 40 degrees. So if this is 40, so then this component is 600 cos of 40, and this component is 600 sine of 40, right? So now this length, this length is that distance d, which is making 90 degree. So this length, this means that this 4 meter length is the perpendicular distance of this f1 from this point of rotation. So this means that if I write moment about O, so then this will be equal to, so far, let's suppose for f1, this distance is, let's suppose, d1, right? And the perpendicular distance of the f2 force, this force, this is the distance for the f2. So let's suppose this is d2, right? So this d2 is the perpendicular distance of this f2 from the point of rotation, right? So then this will be f1 into d plus f2, f1 into d1 and f2 into d2, right? So then f1 is what? F1 is the 600 cos of 40. It's the component of the 600 newton force, right? And d1 is how much? D1 is 4 plus f2. So f2 is how much? 600 sine of 40 degrees into d2. So d2 is 2 meters. It is given. So this distance, this is d2. So if we calculate moment about this point, so again it will be equal to 2610 newton meter. So by applying Verignon's theorem, we get the same moment for this 600 newton force. Now the third method is that by the principle of transmissibility, moving the force to point B. So if the principle of transmissibility says that we can move this force along its line of action as long as its resultant is not affected, right? So if we move this force to this point B, if we move this force to this point B, so then if we find the moment of this force, so then the F2 component, the moment produced by F2 component will become zero. Why? Because this F2 force is passing through this point of rotation, through this axis of rotation. So we have learned that that force which passes through the axis of rotation, that will never produce the rotational effect. So that will not, they will not produce the torque. So in other words, that the, if the component or if the force is passing through the axis of rotation, so it will not produce any moment, right? So here F2 is not producing any moment, only the F1 component of this force is able to produce the moment about this point O, right? So then we need to find the total perpendicular distance of this F1 from the point of rotation. So now if I draw a line here, let's suppose if I draw this line, so we need to find this distance. This distance, so we need to find this distance, so then we will be able to find the total distance of this F1 from the moment, from the axis of rotation. We know this distance, so let's suppose if this distance is x, so then the total distance of this force from the axis of rotation will be how much? So that distance will be, let's suppose I write the total distance will be d1 plus x. So now we need to find this x distance. If this is 40 degrees, right? This is given in the initial diagram. So if this is 40, so then this is also 40. These two angles are vertical angles. And we also know that this length is 2 meters, right? So then we need to find this x distance. So now if I apply 10 40 degree to this triangle, let's suppose I write that here, let's suppose we have this P point, let's suppose, so A, B, P triangle. So if I apply, if I say that triangle A, P, B, if I apply 10, 40 degrees, so then 10, 40, and the perpendicular for this triangle is X, for this theta is, for this 40 degrees is X, the perpendicular, and the base is 2 meters, right? So then x is equal to 2 tan 40 degrees, right? So the perpendicular distance of this f1 component from the axis of rotation is this d. So d1 is 4 plus 2 tan 40 degrees, right? So then if you want to find the moment, the total moment of the force about point O, so then this will be equal to F2 into its perpendicular distance. Let's suppose that distance is, let's suppose D1, right? And then F1 into D. So this becomes 0, right? So we are only left with F1 and its perpendicular distance. So now if I write, so F1 is how much? F1 is 600 cos of 40 degree. It's the component of force along the x-axis, right? And then we will write 4 plus 2 tan 40. So now if we multiply this using calculator, so what we will get? We will get 26 tan newton meter, the same moment. Now we will use the fourth method. So the fourth method is again by the principle of transmissibility, moving the force to point C. Now if we move this force along its action, along its line of action to this point C, so then we can find the moment as well, right? So now the F1 component, the moment produced by F1 component will be equal to 0, and the only component left will be F2, and the total moment will be produced by this F2, right? So now we need to find this d2 distance, this d2 perpendicular distance of this f2 from the axis of rotation. So let's suppose if I draw a triangle here, let's suppose if this is a triangle now, if let's suppose I write this is d, right? So the a, d and c. So this is a, d and c. So if this angle is 40, which is given, so this angle is also 40 degrees. These two are alternate angles, right? So this is also 40. And also, we have solved this triangle as well. We have solved this triangle just before, just in the third method, right? So this was x distance, and this distance was what? This distance was 2, 10, 40 degrees, right? So we know this length, this was x. And this length is 2, right? So as we see here that this is also 40 degrees. So this small triangle and this triangle, this large triangle, both of these are similar triangles. So for similar triangles, the ratio of the corresponding sides are equal, right? So now if let's suppose if I write the distance from this point, the DC distance, let's suppose the DC distance is y, right? And the OD distance is how much? This OD distance is 2 meters. So D2, the distance of F2 from the axis of rotation will be equal to OD plus DC, which is Y, right? So OD is 2 plus Y. So now we need to find this Y. So now if I write Y, this Y distance divided by this AD distance. So AD distance is 4, which is given. So this AD distance is 4 meters, right? So this is given. So this is 4. And now these two triangles are similar triangles. So now if I take the same ratio, so that ratio will be equal. So this will be 2 divided by x, right? This perpendicular distance, right? This is y base divided by perpendicular. So again, this will be base divided by perpendicular. So y divided by 4, this will be equal to 2, and x is 2 tan 40 degrees, right? So this will cancel out. So then y will be equal to 4 divided by tan 40 degrees, or we can write it like this, 4 cot 40 degrees, right? So this is y. So now d2, here if I write d2, so d2 will be equal to 2 plus y. So what is y? Y is 4 cot of 40 degrees. So now if you find the moment about O, so then this moment will be equal to df into d. So now f2 into d2, right? So F2 is how much this F2? So this F2 is the sine component. So this is 600 sine of 40 degrees, right? And into D2. So 2 plus cot 40 degrees. So now if we apply this, if we use calculator, so then again it will be equal to 2610 Newton meter. So this is the third method, the fourth method. Now the fifth method is that by using vector multiplication, that is the cross product. So we know that the moment about point O is R cross F. So if we know the vectors of R and F, so then we will take the cross product of those vectors. So then we will get the moment about O. So this is R vector, right? So this is OA is the R vector. So the components of this R vectors are what? So let's suppose if I write this is the one component of R and this is the second component of R, right? So the length of this component is 2 and this is along x and this is 4 and this is along j, right? So if this is the positive x direction and this is the positive y direction, so then we can write r vector is 2i plus 4j, right? So this is the r vector. And already we have resolved this force into its components. So if I again draw, this is the f1. And here this is the F2 component that we have already discussed here. So now the force vector will be equal to F1i minus F2j. This component is in the negative y direction, right? So F1 is 600 cos of 40 degrees. I minus F2 is 600 sine of 40 degrees towards J, right? So if I solve this, so this comes out to be 460i and minus 386j. So now if we take the cross product of these two, so then what we will get the moment about point O. To take cross product of this R and F, so we will write M about O. So this will be equal to I, J and K. And I will write 2, 4, and the k component of R is 0, right? And this is 460 minus 386, and the k component is 0, right? So now what we will do is that we will draw a line, right? And then we will find the determinant of this. So the determinant of this will be 0. So moment about O will be 0 into I. Right, then what we will do, we will draw another line on J. So we will draw a line like this. So now we will take the determinant of these components, these elements. So again this will be 0 j, right? And now for K, so if I draw lines here, so then we will take the determinant of this. So here I will write 2 into minus 386 minus 460 into 4, right? And then this will be K. So moment about O will be equal to, so this comes out to be minus 2610 K. So this means that the moment produced by this, the cross product of this R and F will be into the page, right? So if we use the right hand rule, so then this moment is a clockwise moment, right? And the direction of this moment will be into the page. So then we will write it like this, right? So the arrow is into the screen or into the page. So this is the direction of this moment. So any of these five methods can be used to find the moment of a particular force, right? So it depends on the scenarios that which method that we can apply in a given problem, right?